Anemia remains a huge problem for GPs around Australia, particularly in women, in pregnancy and in young kids. And as well as that, anemia is really common in patients with other medical conditions. If you go into the hospital, nearly every patient will be anemic. Anemia makes other medical problems worse. If you have ischemic heart disease, anemia will give people more symptoms of angina. If you have lung disease, patients will feel even more short of breath. And we also worry that anemic pregnant women have an increased risk of complications during delivery or that their babies may have complications. So here in Australia, we have some wonderful new treatments for iron deficiency anemia, but anemia remains an enormous problem in low-income countries. About 1.7 billion people around the world are anemic, and that includes about 300 million children under the age of 5. So the concern is that those children will grow up to have a poorer neurocognitive development, poorer growth, and poorer development for themselves and their communities. So the WHO and the United Nations have defined anemia as one of the key targets to be reduced over the next decade, but the world is not making any progress. Our lab aims to discover new knowledge that will ultimately transform the landscape for anemia and enable those reductions in the global burden of anemia to occur. So we're running trials in rural Bangladesh and in rural Malawi in sub-Saharan Africa, where we're trying to find out whether giving iron interventions to young children improves their long-term neurodevelopmental and growth outcomes and makes them feel well and happier overall. We still have a lot to learn about anemia, so in the future, solutions for anemia will probably span beyond iron itself, and we'll be looking at solutions that reduce blood loss, reduce infection, and reduce inflammation. And the goal is that these findings will translate into new therapies for patients in the long term.